As I begin to paint, hold the sky in your hands, as the stretch of my canvas is unknown to me.
I asked Hussain what color he favored most, the way Van Gogh used yellow in his paintings and wrote about it in his letters. Red, he answered promptly, a color reflective of Indian emotions, symbolizing love, evoking passion, manifesting energy. And then I noticed a touch of red in most of his paintings. Some years ago, Hussain painted a mural on the walls of a room at St. James Court Hotel, London. His paintings acquire an entirely new tone in London. But the moment he returned to India, his colors returned in the usual intensity on the first canvas that he painted. February morning, the cool breeze gathered the strewn autumn colors and blew past. Hussain started painting. The vibrancy of the surrounding colors reverberated on the canvas. Hussain held just one color in his hand, black. I sat on the other side of the canvas on a sofa as directed, oblivious of the painting taking shape. Hussain remained behind the canvas, his expressions concealed. I kept wondering what kind of picture he would paint. Often in his paintings, there are images, forms, and colors in composition that arouse a wondrous curiosity. As a member of parliament, Hussain wrote, "Thus, we, the Gang of Four, invaded the parliament en bloc. Cultural invasion. Ravi Shankar with his sitar, R.K. Narayan with his Malgudi days, Amrita Pritham with her powerful Punjabi poetry, and a painter like me. We all sometimes sit together in a row like a comic strip, looking a bunch of strangers surrounded by dealers in the wholesale politics."
Painting a self-portrait, you know, is like trying to understand what is the structure which you see behind, what is behind that structure.
An art critic reviewing his exhibition in 1957 wrote, "Hussain should not paint portraits." Stung by this remark, the following year, Hussain put up a show exclusively of 20 portraits. The same art critic gave him rave reviews this time. The shop of Chamana Bai was across the road from where Maqbool lived in Indore. Her daughter Batul was a beautiful girl. Maqbool was attracted to her. On one occasion, he took her for a joy ride on his father's bicycle. On the way, he showed her so many bicycle tricks that she got scared and resolved never to join him on such an adventure again. Hussain, overwhelmed by emotion, just stood in front of Mother Teresa. All he could do was to stretch out the sketch he had just made of her. She saw it and wrote, "God bless you" on the sketch and signed. One day he went to Mother Teresa's house to meet her. It was a unique experience. He had no words to say. All he could do was to offer with great reverence a portrait of her he had painted. This time, Mother had a good look at the painting and asked, "Where is my face in this? How did you do this?" Hussain went to meet Satyajit Ray in his office in Calcutta. They sat down, and after a brief period of silence, Satyajit picked up a sheet of paper, divided it into two, and gave one piece to Hussain. Each started making a sketch of the other. Once the sketches were complete, they put their respective signatures and started talking about the movie Charulata, starring Satyajit's favorite actress Madhubi. Hussain left after promising to have a coffee with him next month. He started working on the painting Charulata, which showed Satyajit Ray Madhubi with the Nobel laureate Rabindranath Tagore, who was the author of the story. After finishing the painting, Hussain wrote to Satyajit, but before the letter could reach him, the great filmmaker had broken his promise and departed from this world. Hussain went to Calcutta to keep his tryst. In 1997, Hussain decided to make a complete feature film. He wrote the script and wielded the megaphone himself. The title was Gaj Gamani, a woman's gait described by Sanskrit poet as one that has intoxicating sway of an elephant's walk. The film is a reflection of Hussain's life. The scenes on the sets have appeared from his memories. Gaj Gamani, the metaphor of the film, is a Marathi woman from Pandharpur, Hussain's birthplace, wearing a 9-yard yellow langdar sari, purple choli, and bangles on one arm. Quoting Hussain's words, "You live for a moment. 200 years from now, there will be another Hussain. So people of that time should watch his work and understand him. Why should they keep returning to me after 200 years? My paintings should end with my life."
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu Allah.
Khuda ki taqat ki misal Delhi ki Jama Masjid. Lal pattharon se pahadi bhujhala par bani ye masjid insaan ko yaad dilati hai ki uske aage bhi koi aur hai. जिसे हम सब खुदा कहते हैं सदियों से यहां बादशाह और अवाम एक साथ खड़े होकर अल्लाह को याद करते हैं प पत्थर की सीढ़ियां, ऊंचे दरवाजे, चौकोर सहन और धारीदार सफेद गुंबद मुगल कारीगरी की खास पहचान। इस मस्जिद को बनवाया शाहजहां ने और बनाया 5000 कारीगरों ने। 1644 और 1658 के बीच में बनी इस शानदार इमारत का नाम पहले मस्जिद-ए-जहांनुमा पड़ा, यानी वो मस्जिद जहां से सारा जहां दिखाई देता। मुहर्रम के दिन जब यहां से ताजिया निकलता है, सैकड़ों लोग मातम करते हुए, मरसिया पढ़ते हुए करबला की तरफ चलते हैं, तो उन लम्हों के लिए लगता है कि वक्त रुक सा गया है। इक्कीसवीं सदी की पहचान रात की स्याही में घुलकर बीते हुए अरसे की याद दिला रही है। एक ही सफ में खड़े हो गए महमूदो अयाज, न कोई बंदा रहा और न कोई